Bad man gay, yeah. Oh, oh. She already know I be one man more poor. Come on my own. Would you give me the keys to your heart if you love me? Will you hold me down? Will you sing for me? Would you give me the keys to your heart if you love me? Will you hold me down? Baby, smile for me. Me wanna love you. Me wanna love you.
My dear, the Roses family is here.
Dad.
I have never ever said no to you on anything before. But this, it's a no for me. Your decisions and arrangement does not go well with my person. I'm sorry, I can't.
No. You can. And you will.
Yes. Dad.
Yes.
You're taking this way too far. There is no way that I am going to agree to something that I know will make my life miserable.
Come on, Cynthia.
Of course.
Yeah, good morning. Gorgeous is family and close to us.
Yeah.
They need to cement this relationship. And their son, Ben, is such a handsome boy.
Certainly,
Father.
I agree. But for Cynthia,
calm
down and let that ruin my life. No, no. Dad, gone are the days where parents choose husband or wife for their children. Thereby, like making them, they were making them lack all the love and attention that they need. These days, children go out there to find love, relationship, and commitment. And then they bring who they want to their parents for approval. And not this way of wanting to take the old ways into the present.
So you have become a lecturer now, right?
Why don't you put aside your face? Do this to permanently sustain the relationship. It will make us very happy.
Wow. Mom, so my happiness doesn't matter. As long as the two families are happy, right? I didn't know I was a sacrificial lamb. Going on today, your mentorship has broken my heart. Yes. Please, I beg you in the name of God, please, Dad, do not destroy the love that we have in this family. I beg you.
Oh, this, please sit down. Sit down, because it's sit down. Sit down, please. I'd like to apologize for the outburst of my daughter. I know you must have overheard the conversation, but I can assure you that I'll talk to her and she'll come around.
And we mean no disrespect, Mr. Lucas. And your daughter might be right.
She was not properly informed. She is a lady with her own policy.
What policy are you talking about now?
Mr. Lucas, you see, Cynthia, she's very brilliant. And as I can see, she is a lady that whatever she wants to do, if you want to convince her, you must have to carry her along. Please, I want to beg you, allow her to make her decisions. And Ben,
I think I love her philosophy and the kind of person. If she was to accept me, I wouldn't say anything because she's perfect. See, if I was in her shoes, I would have reacted and behaved the same way. However, my parents have always told me that someday our families will live more on the common ground as in-laws. So I believe that Cynthia is going to be my wife someday. It's rather disheartening that things turned out this way. Please, I want to beg the both families to just respect her feelings and let her be. Please.
Oh my goodness. I'm enlightened the way Ben, my nephew, just spoke. I want to beg you, allow your daughter to make her decisions. We have established good relationship and I wouldn't want us to end it in a disastrous way. Please, I beg you, if it is the will of God that they are going to be together as one, I know nothing will stop it. Alright, so, shall we leave?
Would you give me the keys to your heart if you love me? Will you hold me down? Will you sing for me? Would you give
me the keys? Good morning, Jess. Good morning. Hi. I'm okay. You look far different from what I expected. Like, with what happened yesterday, I thought the helm was going to let loose.
Well, let's just say that, you know, the table turned out in my favor.
You mean the Rogers aren't mad at you?
Ironically, no. Well, according to that, he said that the Rogers, especially Ben, respected my feelings and decisions and that I should be left alone. So, hey.
Wow.
Can you stop? Wow. You sound like a siren.
I'm just happy for you.
Thank you, my dear. I am so happy for me. Just imagine, like, somebody
who sing for me.
It's insane. Thank you.
Baby, smile for me. So sweet. How was my interview with Mr. Babbitt? He called to tell me of how wonderful you were. And he can't wait to work with you. As I can't wait for you to work with them.
Dad, I can't wait also.
But why did you tell him you were my daughter?
Dad, because I wanted it based on merits. Yes, and this also goes a long way to talk about my philosophy about life. And that is why I'm into a relationship with a man who's got great potential, self-made.
Than
someone who
leverages
on his father's
affluence. That's my future. And with this philosophy, you will go far.
Of course, you'll gain success.
Thank you, Dad. Great.
Hours to Cynthia's birthday.
Yes.
Man, tell me, what are you going to buy? Because I know Daddy.
I have already spoken to the cake maker to bake her an exquisite cake.
No, not just one cake. Two exquisite cakes.
Now I'm jealous.
What? It's not just your birthday. What's your birthday? You can get something like
well,
that.
Well, your mama and I planned to get Cynthia a car.
Yay!
She deserves it, so at this point in time, she will get A car gift?
Yeah. Daddy, two cars. Three.
You haven't achieved until you
shush! Did you hear me, Daddy? Achieve!
Go ahead. I will.
Dad, Mom.
Yeah?
Let me tell you a secret. She's planning a birthday party at the club with her friends.
I'm really? Going.
You beware. You don't go anywhere.
That's
anything.
Not a secret.
It's a secret. You're not supposed to.
You always know Cindy.
Yes!
Secrets.
Of course. She's my dearest sis.
Is she?
Dearest sis.
But maybe we'll just meet at the club as usual.
Wow, okay. See you later then.
Alright, now see you later.
Anyways, well, let's
simple cake guy.
Mm-hmm.
Bad.
Okay.
Yeah, the kind of guy that I like.
Oh.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Hey, girls.
What's excitement about this morning?
Mom. Girls talk.
Exactly.
Whatever. Anyway, I've made breakfast.
Oh wow.
Mm-hmm.
That's good. After you.
Yeah, sure.
I'm hungry, right?
Let me hold your ass. Let me tell you, daddy. Will you give me the keys to your heart if you love me? Will you hold me down?
Yeah, I was thinking of making another one. Really? Yes, ma'am. Would you give me the keys to your heart? Mommy, the phone. It's Cindy.
Oh, okay. You. Remember you kept something on fire?
Yeah.
Rabbit, left something on fire.
Hello, dear.
How are you? It's all right, my love. I'll see you later.
Love you.
Yeah, would you give me the keys to your heart if you love me? Will you hold me down? Will you sing for me? Would you give me the keys to your heart if you love me? Will you hold me down? Baby, smile for me. Me wanna love you. Me wanna love you. Me wanna kiss your body. Me wanna touch you.
Pat? What do you actually think you're doing?
Picking Dad's grey hair.
Picking Dad's grey hairs? Are you the one that's supposed to be doing that? Or I am the person that's supposed to be doing it?
Mom, who is my daddy?
Oh, really? Your daddy. Better get it from there.
Mommy, don't be jealous.
What is it?
Don't be jealous, mommy.
No way.
Dinner is served.
Oh, so soon?
Yes, mommy.
Oh, it's just a pity. Cindy can join us.
Why, while I'm here?
She has to attend to something urgently.
Really?
We have to eat dinner with her.
Fantastic. Apologies, I'm just really excited because I'm around you. And you know, initially I was skeptical that you wouldn't give me a chance to be close to you and nice to you, considering your family status.
Baby, for your love, I'll go cross any mountain. Just for your love, I'll go do anyhow, yeah. Let me touch your body, let me know you better. Let me hold you.
Would you give me the kiss to your heart? Hello? Yeah, Cindy. I hear you are out with a friend. Bring him home.
No problem.
Yeah. Let's have dinner tomorrow.
Okay, I will. Bye.
Okay, you go ahead. I'll okay. Come after you.
Yeah.
Yes, mommy.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's go. Yeah, let's go. Are you serious? Like he wants to meet me?
Yeah.
Okay. When does he want to see me?
Well,
as soon as possible. I'm very excited.
Would you give me the keys to your heart if you love me? Will you hold me down?
Baby, smile for me.
I am highly honored.
It's time to know this young man that has stolen the heart of our angel.
Yes.
Well, my name is Ademola Adekunle. I am an orphan, one who survived by his skin of the teeth, but I do not entertain any pity because I do consider myself to be a survivor.
I graduated with a first degree from Obafemi Awolowo University in civil engineering. And then I went ahead to obtain my master's.
Currently, I work as a senior manager at a very reputable contracting firm, FKJ Contractors. A position that I rose to in less than 2 years, having received 3 excellence awards. I do believe myself to be a one-man squad.
Because I believe strongly in myself, and I never ever leverage on the success of others. Sir, I feel highly privileged to be here with your lovely family and really honored to be having this one-on-one conversation with you.
But what I most cherish is how blessed you are to have such a beautiful, brilliant, calculating goddess as a daughter, whose fantastic philosophies to life I highly admire.
Interesting. I'm actually, we're very glad that you accepted my invite.
Thank you very much.
Please, let's eat.
Yeah.
Bon appétit.
Yes,
sweetheart.
Well,
the young man has quite impressive credentials.
Mm-hmm.
He's handsome.
Yes.
He's hardworking.
Mm-hmm.
And from what I see, he's a good boy. Well.
And he is a humble and respectful
man. But it's something I can't quite put a finger on. I can't quite understand.